When you think about climate change, how does the image that pops up in your head look like? Pretty doom and gloom, I guess. Well, today I want to challenge that image. Psychology wonders, how can we be resilient in the face of climate change and bounce back, which typically means maintaining or recovering what we have? As a psychologist, I think we need a broader perspective. In fact, we cannot deny that because of climate change, we are also changing. We're getting creative, we're looking for alternatives, we're innovating. So for my PhD, I want to understand whether people perceive they can adapt to climate change, but especially whether they perceive they can do more than bounce back. We therefore introduce the construct transilience. Transilience comprises three components. First, I want to understand whether people perceive they can be brave and stay determined in the face of climate change. We call this persistence. Second, I want to understand whether people perceive they have many options to adapt to climate change, even if they don't know the details, as this openness is crucial when it comes to adjusting or switching between strategies. We call this adaptability. Third, I want to understand whether people perceive they can positively transform by adapting to climate change. For instance, learn something good or grow. We call this transformability. After defining it, I needed a tool to measure transilience. So I developed a scale, basically a set of questions that allows me to give people a score that indicates the level of their transilience. I then included this transilience scale in a series of questionnaires that I have used to conduct empirical studies. So far, I found that transilience has the three components, that on average, people do perceive they can persist, adapt flexibly, and positively transform in the face of climate change, and that the more they do so, so the higher their transilience, the more they take concrete action to adapt to climate change. The more they support policies for adaptation, and remarkably, the higher their general well-being. There's a proverb I love that says, when the wind of change blows, some people build walls while others build windmills. I think transilience provides a useful and positive perspective on how we can adapt to adversities such as climate change. And I hope that when you think about it now, that image that pops up in your head is slightly more hopeful. Thank you.